It's great you learn about Bayes' rule. And one of the things we use Bayes' rule a lot for is learning from documents or text learning. And the method that I'll tell you about is often called naive Bayes'. It's actually a misnomer. It's not really naive, not as naive as Bayes' rule itself, but that's the name, okay? So you're going to exercise this later in our practice exams using Enron email data sets, but I give you the gist of it. Suppose we have two people. One is called Chris and one is called Sarah. And both people write a lot of email. And for simplicity, I'll assume that these emails only contain three words, okay? They contain the word love, the word deal, and the word life. Same is true about Sarah. Obviously, people use more than three words, but this area here is a little bit small for 30,000 words. The difference of these two people, Chris and Sarah, is in the frequency at which she uses those words. And just for simplicity, let's say Chris loves talking about deals. So 80% of his words, or 0.8, are deal. And he talks about life and love quite a bit with 0.1 probability. So if Chris utters a word in email, he's going to 80% of the time use the word deal and 10% of the time love or life. But Sarah talks more about love, a little bit about deals, 0.2, and about life, 0.3. And again, that's a simplified example. What naive Bayes allows you to do is to determine, based on a random email, who is the likely person who sent this email. Suppose there's an email that goes as follows: love, life. And you don't know who sent it, but you'd like to figure that out. Then you can do this based on Bayes' rule. And suppose you believe a priori that it's a 50% probability by Chris or by Sarah. So if we say P of Chris equals 0.5, that means the prior probability for it being Chris is 50%. And that immediately means, because it's from one of the two, that probability of Sarah is also 0.5. So if you look at this intuitively, who's more likely to have written this email, Chris or Sarah? Just check one box.